Hello, everybody. Welcome back to Altium Academy. I'm your host, Zach Peterson. Today, we're going to be answering your questions that came in on our recent video about drill drawings. Now, when we put out this video on drill drawings, we got some really good questions about drill drawings specifically, as well as the role of fabrication drawings more broadly in PCB manufacturing. So that's what we're going to look at today. And we'll even look at some example fabrication drawings, fabrication notes, and drill drawings to really show what these drawings are used for. Let's go ahead and hop in and get started. Now, as I mentioned in the introduction, we put out a video about creating drill tables recently. And in that video, we got some great questions from folks in the audience asking about what is the role of a drill drawing, as well as fabrication drawings more generally. The fabrication drawing for your PCB holds all of the requirements needed to manufacture that PCB with any fabrication house. And that's really the whole point of creating a fabrication drawing. The other reason is that it functions as a check against the data that you export from your PCB layout. And we'll see how that arises here in just a moment. But first, let's take a look at those viewer questions. Inductive Thinking writes, do manufacturers even look at drill drawings? I have the suspicion that most PCB manufacturers just look at the Gerbers, maybe some notes, and completely ignore all additional files. Some low-cost Chinese sites even explicitly state that they will only look at the Gerbers. Well, Inductive Thinking, I can tell you certainly yes, manufacturers do look at a fabrication drawing if you supply one. Now, some PCB manufacturer websites have a quote form that you can fill out, and you can specify things like plating, you can specify, for example, minimum hole size, your target line width and spacing, those types of requirements in the quote form. And the primary purpose of that quote form is to give you a price estimate very quickly. But at the end of the day, they still have to look at the files you give them in order to give you a solid quote for building that board. Now, if you include a fabrication drawing in your file package, they will look at that fabrication drawing. And one of the things that they're looking for is to see if any of the specifications in your fabrication drawing differ from what you put into their quote form, and to see if those specifications differ from what they see in the PCB file outputs. Tiagi99 writes, why would the fabricators want to see these drawings? I mean, for complex designs, is it even understandable? And I'm sure nobody would be drilling manually or even using semi-automatic because it could cause errors. Or maybe I am wrong, I just don't know much about the fabrication end of PCB manufacturing. Now that question is specifically referencing a drill drawing, but of course a drill drawing is part of your fabrication drawing. And I can tell you with certainty, no, they are not using the drill drawing for manual drilling of all of the holes in your PCB. One of the things they're doing with that drill drawing is, again, they're using it as a check against the NC drill data that you export from your PCB layout file. And they can see graphically where the drills should be, and they can use that as a check against the numerical data that comes in that NC drill file. The other thing that you can specify in a drill drawing is, of course, tolerances. And those tolerances are very important, especially if you have tight positional tolerances, and they need to know if that's a requirement that you have on that board. Because if they deviate too much from those positional tolerances, then you might raise hell with them and want to have the boards rebuilt. Now, as we'll see momentarily, you want to also include the dimensions of the PCB, as well as the dimensions of any slots, any tooling sizes, and then the dimensions of any cutouts in the PCB when you create your drill drawing. So I can tell you with confidence that yes, if you supply a fabrication drawing with your file package to a PCB manufacturer, they will look at it and they will use it as a master specification. Now let's take a look at an example drill drawing for a project that I've shown in some other videos, and we can really see why this document is so important. Now here I'm inside of Altium Designer, and you can see here I have a fabrication drawing open using the Draftsman tool. When we just scroll through the pages quickly, we can see that we have all of the data that a manufacturer would need to understand what we want to build in this project. Now, some of the important data that we have that causes our fabrication drawing to function as a master specification are really three things. One of those is, of course, the stackup drawing right here. Now, if you're doing anything where you're selecting a specific material for your PCB, then you need to provide a stackup drawing. Now, it is standard practice to put that stackup drawing into the fabrication drawing because it is, of course, something that they will be fabricating from base materials. So you want to include that in the fabrication drawing, as I've done here. The other piece of information that we have in here that causes our fabrication drawing to be the master specification for our PCB is, of course, the fabrication notes. And inside the fabrication notes, you can see all of the specifications that we might put into a quote form on the manufacturer's website. Now, I've shown, just as an example, the quote form from Sunstone Circuits many times. The quote form from Sunstone Circuits asks you about a lot of these aspects that you see here in the fabrication notes. So, for example, the solder mask color. What is the plating finish that you want on exposed conductors? What's the copper weight? What is the overall thickness? Now, the fabrication notes allow you to go a little bit deeper because you can see here in the fabrication drawing, I am specifying tolerances in my fabrication notes. That's very important because a lot of professional projects are going to have mechanical tolerances that need to be enforced in different areas of the board, and the fabrication drawing is the place you specify that. You don't really specify that in a quote form. Some other information that we see here in the fabrication notes that cause this document to be the master specification for our design are, for example, found right here in note 11. Here, this gives some more detail on the specific dielectric that we're looking for. This is a Rogers 4835, but we're specifically asking for an unreinforced Rogers 4835 with a specific copper applied to the base material. Now, this is really important in some designs because that unreinforced Rogers 4835 with that specific low pro copper is going to be required in this type of project because this is a millimeter wave sensor board. And then, for example, here, cap and filling on vias. This isn't always specified on quote forms. This is something that you would have to put into a note and send over to the manufacturer. And so, of course, you would want to include it in the fabrication notes and leverage your fabrication drawing as the master specification for your project. The third major piece of information that causes our fabrication drawing to be like a master specification is, of course, this drill table and this drill drawing. And taken together, this tells the manufacturer where all of these via spans that you see in the stackup drawing are located in the PCB. Now, one of the things that the fabrication house is going to do when they look at your design is they're going to open up all of your fabrication data and they're going to compare that to your master specification just to make sure that there's no disagreements. Whenever any of those files don't match each other, they're then going to send you an email asking you to clarify, and you're going to have to make a decision which way you want to go with the design. So, for example, if I were to send them a design that specified 409 of these blind vias in this fabrication drawing, but my drill drawing contained 500 vias, then they're going to ask me, hey, why does your NC drill data mismatch from your fabrication drawing? Because again, the fabrication drawing is the master specification that's being used to build the board. Now, just as an example, when we look at the drill table and the drill drawing, we can actually pull open the NC drill data, and they can very quickly compare the number of drill hits of each size to the number of drill hits specified in the NC drill file. So, for example, you can see here that we have all of the drill sizes listed here in this first part of the NC drill file. You can see here that the 0.0374 drill, that is this entry right here, in the drill table. That's the 37.402 mil plated holes. And if we go back here, we see that this is T13. So we can find T13 using the search bar. And then you can see here, if we scroll down to this lower part of the drill file, we just count up the number of holes here. You can see that there are 9 holes specified in the NC drill file, and there are 9 holes specified in our drill table. So great. That part of the data aligns. So this is some of the review that the CAM department is going to do when they receive your file package, just to make sure that your master specification and your manufacturing files are all in alignment. So we've covered the information in a fabrication drawing that causes your drawing to be like the master specification for your design. But it was mentioned in one of the questions that some low-cost Chinese manufacturers will only review the Gerbers. They won't review a fabrication drawing. So how do you get this fabrication information in front of them if they're only going to be looking at Gerber files? Well, there is a way to do that. What you can do is you can put the fabrication data into the PCB layout file as I'm showing here on screen. So if I just change the view color here, it's going to be a little bit easier to see. We'll go ahead and make it white. Now what you can see here in this fabrication drawing is we've put a title block, we've put all of the fabrication data directly into the PCB layout file in a mechanical layer. And you can see right here it's been put into the drill drawing layer. So the drill drawing layer is not just all your drill symbols, you can actually put all of this additional fabrication information into that drill drawing layer. How do you get this into a Gerber file? Well, that's very simple. If we just go up here to File, Fabrication Outputs, and then we select Gerber Files, we can then export a Gerber file that just contains this drill drawing information. Now, of course, when I bring up the Gerber setup dialog, you can see here all of the copper layers, silk screen, solder mask, and paste mask are all brought up by default. But if we just scroll down here, we can select drill drawing right here on the right-hand side with this checkbox. If we include that drill drawing in the export, it is going to put all of the data that you see here in this drill drawing, as well as all of the drill symbols, and take that and put it into a Gerber file. And you can include that Gerber file with your file package that you provide to that manufacturer. Now, I am personally a fan of PDF files because oftentimes you have to send that fabrication drawing to someone who doesn't have a Gerber viewer just so that they can look at it. So you shouldn't really expect that everyone's going to be able to look at your Gerber files. But what you can do if you are going to send this file package to a manufacturer is you can really just export both. You can export your fabrication drawing as a PDF, and then you can create an exact copy of that as a Gerber file using the method here that I've shown on screen. That way you can make sure that the manufacturer has both files and they can use whatever file they want. Thanks for watching this video, everybody. I'm going to try and do more videos on data management, including manufacturing data management, because it is very important if you're transitioning from a hobby project to professional projects. Make sure to hit that like button, hit that subscribe button, leave your comments and questions in the comments section, and don't forget to call your fabricator, folks. We'll see you next time.